everyone, this is Doris from the Art and Nature Center, and I'd like to wish you a happy Arbor Day today. We are going to be making some paper tube trees in honor of the trees that provide us oxygen every day outside. So if you can't make it to the forest this week, maybe you can bring the forest to yourself. This project is fairly simple. I need a paper towel tube that we're going to be recycling. Sometimes you've got white ones, sometimes you've got brown ones. I like the different colors because this one looks like a birch tree. This one's a maple tree. You can tell by the leaf shape I did. I am going to make this one into a willow tree. I'm going to cut some strips into the top of my tube here that go down about 1/3 of the way, maybe a little further since I want to make this a willow tree. So I want the branches to be kind of long. If you are worried about making straight lines, you can always mark it with a pencil. They don't need to be perfectly straight. You could do a thicker one that has two branches at the end. I did that on this one. I cut two branches into one strip there. It's nice to have bigger scissors because they reach further. If you're using littler scissors, it's harder to cut all the way up. Just make sure you have an adult with you to supervise this part here. This one I'm gonna make into two branches because it's kind of wide. Now, before I stretch these all out to become branches, I'm gonna draw some bark lines onto my tree. And you can look at some real trees outside. You can pull up some pictures of a tree for leaf shapes and bark lines. And then I also like to put the lines onto the branches a little bit. And then I'm gonna start stretching out all of my branches. And I want this to look like a willow tree, so I'm gonna bend them very steeply downwards. I'm just using all my fingers. I'm not really pulling, I'm more just rubbing to crease them as I fold them down. The paper towel tubes are a lot thicker than if you make your own paper tube, so they're a little bit tougher to fold. But regular construction paper actually bends down pretty easily just with the weight of the leaves once you start adding the leaves. Now I'm gonna use these two colors of paper to cut some leaves for my tree. Now I do wanna talk about how trees are cut down to make paper. So it's a great idea to use recycled paper that you might have left over to make this project, and you can draw on the color. We wanna reuse as much paper as we can. So using recycled materials like your paper tubes and old scrap paper that you can cut up and color on is a great idea for this project, especially since we're trying to honor the trees today. So you can do some different sizes of leaves. I folded the paper so I can cut a bunch at once rather than having to cut each one individually. And then any of your scrap paper definitely wants to go in your recycling bin so it can be turned into new paper products. Now I'm going to pick out some leaves and start gluing them onto my tree form here. So when I'm gluing, I like to hold the smaller piece and put it against the glue like this so that I don't have to glue against the table and get everything all sticky. You can alternate between the top and bottom of your branches, alternate between different colors and shapes and sizes of leaf. You can glue a couple leaves together first and then glue them onto your branches. And the way you decorate the branches is all up to what you think looks good, how you want your little tree and your little forest to look when you're done. And if you do manage to get out and check out some trees in person before you do this project, you can look at how their leaves grow on their branches, if they're alternating, if they line up with each other. Some trees have a lot thicker foliage than others. Maybe instead of leaves, it has needles, and you cut a bunch of straight lines to glue on. Maybe your tree has heart-shaped leaves, similar to a ginkgo tree. And remember, not all trees have green leaves. You could give it red leaves or yellow leaves. Some types of conifers, trees with needles, some of them look blue even. I love the shadows that this particular project casts. You can have a lot of fun with arranging your trees and your extra leaves in a nice sunny spot, just like the real trees in the forest would like. I hope you enjoy this project, and I hope you make a lovely forest of your own, and also make it outside to visit some of your local trees. Have a great Arbor Day and a great week. Bye!